Who is this phenomenal woman?
She is our mothers, our grandmothers, our great-grandmothers, and female ancestors who have come before us. She hails as a queen from the great continent, forced into labor, and to bear fruit that was frequently ripped from her nurture.
Bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave, I am the dream and the hope of the slave. I rise.
I rise.
I rise.
She is the strength who sacrificed, scrubbed floors, did laundry, and took care of other babies so that she had the means to take care of her own.
Life for me ain't been no crystal stair. It's had tacks in it, and splinters, and boards torn up, and places with no carpet on the floor. Bare. Langston Hughes.
She is the one with prayers and dreams for a better future, for her children and her children's children. Living on her knees, appealing to Jesus for a better tomorrow.
Never underestimate the power of dreams and the influence of the human spirit. We are all the same in this notion. The potential for greatness lives within each of us. Wilma Rudolph.
She is the one who exposed the evil of racism through her son's brutalized body after his murder in Money, Mississippi.
Let the people see. The murder of my son has shown me that what happens to any of us, anywhere in the world, had better be the business of all of us. Mamie Till Mobley.
She is the one who refused to give up her seat on the bus.
I knew someone had to take the first step, and I made up my mind not to move. Rosa Parks.
She is the one who marched into the schoolhouse, alone or with her peers, eyes straight ahead, as she experienced jeers, expletives, and spit.
As I stepped out into the street, the people who had been across the street started surging forward behind me. So, I headed in the opposite direction to where there was another bus stop. Safety to me meant getting to that bus stop. It seemed like I sat there for a long time before the bus came. In the meantime, people were screaming behind me. What I would have described as a crowd before, to my ears, sounded like a mob. Elizabeth Eckford of Little Rock Nye.
Great morning, faculty, staff, administration, students, guests, and welcome to the 2022 Black History Month program presented by Bishop McNamara's Black Cultural Alliance. I am Mr. Mason Calloway, the moderator of our BCA, and on behalf of our organization, we thank you for your support and participation. Our theme this year, as decided by our general body, is entitled From the Ground to Glory. This is representative of our history of learning to turn nothing into something. We have historically taken lemons and turned that into lemonade. We have been given little, and we have shown time and time again that we can make that great. Our demonstrations today will pay homage to that idea and hopefully inspire us all to persevere toward that glory. Our first performance is a beautiful rendition of the Black National Anthem, Lift Every Voice and Sing, by our very own Anaya Jones, under the direction of Miss Sutton. We hope you enjoy.
Lift every voice and sing to earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Facing the rising
Lovely. Beautifully done, Anaya. And that's how you get us started the right way. This next act barely needs any introduction at all. Their attention to detail and perfection of their craft tell all the story. Without further ado, performing next is our traditional African music and dance level 4 group under the direction of Mr. Ba and Ms. Hairston.
Thank you.
That's the energy we can count on. Special thanks to our African dance program for that wonderful artistic display. Our next piece is an introspective one. We have the ability to be creative in so many ways, and we recognized long ago the power of our words. Whether we are considering the powerful faith-filled sermons from Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., or a deeply personal and provocative work of poetry from Ms. Maya Angelou, we understand that words can move people. Words can move mountains. Here to give us the gift of spoken word is the Poetry Club, led by Ms. Koenig.
I want to march like Martin Luther King. I want to preach to my people like Reverend Sharpton, because the Lord's words are the only words I got to bring. Told y'all catchy hooks ain't the only words I sing.
Killed to me a rising was scantily about the house for a big portion of my life. But we realize as young black kids in the darkest corners, we gotta be alive. To my mama, I catch March in February. I'm going from January to January, left and right.
NWA taught me how to stand up. Kendrick taught me that even when you're getting bullied off the mic, out of courtesy, you gotta man up.
Told you boys 2 years ago that BLM is a lot more than wearing a shirt and putting your hand up.
Michael Jackson told me to always be myself, and no matter how much fame I acquire, I can't be nobody else. Jordan taught me about the significance of dedication, not only into my performance, but also my preparation. Malcolm X and Frederick Douglass taught me that even if you sit at the table, you gotta use your royal voice to enter the conversation.
But on a lighter note, on a beacon of hope.
I want that Martin and Gina love, where just being there was beyond, and it was never a hassle to go above. But I don't know what to say about Jada and Will.
Chill, want my black queens and kings to go to college and shoot. You might find love like Dwayne and Whitley.
Who with me?
So all my young women continue to set trends. I should carry your flow, Joe.
See me?
I know these jokers out here like curly hair, but don't be afraid to let that fro flow, yo.
To all my entertainers, pop, lock, drop, wear linen, crop top. Then they do all because they're going to eat up every piece, even if they look at you like a clown. I mean, look at how they try to track and drive me around.
Hey, before it's my turn to let the mic pass, hold fast to your dream, because when the cage bird sings, my soul goes deep.
Like the rivers.
Brought the table and I'd be a mad somebody. We've been fighting for 400 plus years just to get in line to get slippers. Like James Baldwin said, anyone who's ever struggled with poverty knows how extremely expensive it is to be poor. That line right there should let y'all know it's a lot more than black lives he's fighting for.
Everybody put a fist up.
The right one.
This is every black man that was gunned down without reason.
This for every whip crack.
This for every joke crack.
This for each of the 400 years plus that we can never get back.
This for every forgotten child.
This for this month as men and for the public thinking that us marching with our shirts on and our arms locked is mild.
This is for all the hardships we made it through. This is for whatever may happen in 2022.
This is for the culture. Won't you come celebrate with me?
For my people are finally starting to feel their freedom to lie beyond the shackles.
Won't you come celebrate with?
For my people have marched until victory was won, and now thousands have made it over six figures in our yearly income.
Won't you come celebrate?
For now, we are pouring more into our HBCUs, shifting our choices from PWIs from number one into two.
Won't you come?
All the black excellence that has come to man and best. Fighting back against the stereotypes, but we do best.
Won't you understand
and recognize that all my people have overcome? Also become aware of the rain that has just begun.
Won't you
see that we still rise despite all those who despise?
Won't you come celebrate with me?
That every day something that has tried to limit us has failed.
As now we are facing the rising sun because we learned to keep our heads up like Pop in the light of Martin, dream for a great life yet to come.
Wow. I don't know about you, but that piece has me in a state of reflection. That was powerful indeed. I think it's appropriate that our next performance features words from the late, great Maya Angelou in the form of classical dance. Under the direction of Miss Cindy King, we present to you our classical dance group performing to Phenomenal Woman.
Phenomenal Woman. Many people wonder where my secret lies. I'm not cute or built to suit a fashion model size. When I start to tell them, they think I'm telling lies. I say, it's in the reach of my arms, the span of my hips, the stride of my step, the curl of my lips. I'm a woman, phenomenally. I walk into a room just as cool as you please, and to a man the fellows stand or fall down on their knees. Then they swarm around me, a hive of honeybees. I say, it's the fire in my eyes, the flash of my teeth, the swing in my waist, the joy in my feet. I'm a woman, phenomenally. Men themselves have wondered what they see in me. They try so much, but they can't touch my inner mystery. When I try to show them, they say they still can't see. I say, it's in the arch of my back, the sun of my smile, the ride of my breasts, the grace of my style. I'm a woman, phenomenally. Now you understand just why my head's not bowed. I don't shout or jump about or have to talk real loud. When you see me passing, it ought to make you proud. I say, it's in the click of my heels, the bend of my hair, the palms of my hands, the need for my care. Because I'm a woman, phenomenally, phenomenal woman. That's my mother and all your mothers, and my grandmothers, and your grandmothers, and my great-grandmothers, and your greats, and my great-greats, and your and all you women, and me.
Fantastic. Did you see how gracefully they did that? I'm sure Miss Angelou would be very proud to have seen that. Great work, classical dance. I'm really excited about what's coming next. As much emphasis as we have been putting on spoken word, it's also important to make sure that everyone can access its beauty. Our deaf and hard of hearing brothers and sisters have lots to share and express as well. And we have a duty to make sure that we open up and receive those voices. I am grateful and proud to introduce our American Sign Language program next in our event.
Elegant. Here we go. Woman, angelically poised. Heavy-hearted and worried, yet wholesomely calm. At peace knowing she's forever blessed. Treasuring her melanin-colored skin, a gift of her Afrocentric beauty. She knows that the Holy Spirit would always reward her faithfulness.
I love being a part of a community that embraces all ethnicities, all cultures, all walks of life. Bishop McNamara is a special place, and seeing what our ASL program contributes to our space is gratifying, moving, and empowering. Thank you all so much for that. Up next in our program is a special performance from our TAP program under the direction of Miss Cindy King. Pay special attention to this one. You may see a performer here that you might not have expected. Check it out.
I'm
Shout out to Mr. Mills for joining with our current TAP students for that demonstration. It's always great to see our faculty and students working together, not only in the classroom, but for our passions that exist outside of it. As you can see, our students are very gifted and they have a lot to say. They are visual artists, dancers, musicians, poets, writers. They are also activists. They stand for something. They stand for people. They stand for worthy causes, and we can learn from them. Coming up, we are going to hear the perspective of multiple students in a compilation put together by the Social Justice Club.
What does blackness mean to you?
Blackness means to me that we are excellent, we are kings and queens, and that we know where we've come from and how to rise above that. But I know some people that know things better than I do.
Blackness means to me power.
Beautiful.
Excellent.
Rich embracing culture. Your culture.
Yeah,
smart.
Rich culture.
Strong. Empowerment.
Representation.
Individuality, a whole culture built off torture, built off of nothingness, made in something amazing, something beautiful.
A culture of creativity and just prosperity and having faith in the future and continuing to strive and evolve.
Greatness.
Excellence.
Intelligence.
Like just being of African descent. Knowing your heritage and embracing who you are authentically and truly.
Me as a community.
Being able to wear your natural hair and just be your most authentic self, I feel like.
Resiliency.
Embracing your true self inside and out despite all the challenges. It's embracing your culture, hairstyles, everything that has to do with being yourself.
Me being proud of where you came from.
What is your most memorable Black experience?
My most memorable Black experience was probably when I shadowed into one school, and I remember like everybody was looking at me weird because it was a predominantly white school, and also the administration asked like if I would need academic help.
I think the feeling after I got after watching Black Panther, because I felt more empowered as a person and seeing myself being represented in something so big in that cinematic
masterpiece.
Would probably be the Million Man March with my dad.
When I went to college, actually, I went to PWI. I feel like that's when I discovered my blackness. You know, PG County sheltered you a bit. So going out there, I realized how racist the world is.
At the Black History Assembly that we usually have here, it was about 2 years ago, and we were just showcasing all our different talents, and it just made me realize how creative Black people can be.
Traveling the country to see that many Black people have similar experiences.
What is the future of blackness in America?
The future of blackness in America, I think it's headed in the right direction, but I don't think it's quite there. Like, there are many Black people that are being elevated to higher roles and stuff like that, but I still think there's work to be done.
I feel like it would be self-awareness and just understanding where we come from.
I hope some success, some justice, some equality. I hope we don't keep seeing Black people dying just for being Black.
I think it's a lot of opportunities and a lot of upcoming power. We see it with like all the athletes are starting, we're starting to pull more into our HBCUs. People are starting to become more successful and start million-dollar businesses. And I think it's just gonna be a really empowering atmosphere.
To me, the future of blackness is optimistic.
I can't say enough about how important it is to hear our students. While we absolutely must honor our history and what came before us, the future is bright with young people like these at the forefront of our social justice movements and initiatives. I am proud to know them and so many others like them. Now let's get into some more powerful movement, quite literally. If you want to see what presence looks like, then look no further than this next performance from our very own STEP team under the direction of Miss Wills. magical. I mean, just magical. They never cease to amaze me. Every time the STEP team performs, it's like seeing them for the first time. I love it. Well, we are coming toward the end of our Black History Month program, but not before we round out our performances with a collaborative effort between two great groups. This is what it's all about. Working together, being expressive, and making sure everyone can take part in the joys of art, motion, history, and performance. Last but certainly not least, it's time to enjoy our student-led rendition of John Legend and Common Song Glory, performed by classical dance and interpreted by our American Sign Language students.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure. No man, no weapon formed against, yes, glory is destined. Everyday women and men become legends. Sins that go against our skin become blessings. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. Justice is juxtaposition in us. Justice for all just ain't specific enough. One son died, the spirit is revisiting us. True and living in us. Resistance is us. That's why Rosa sat on the bus. That's why we walk through Ferguson with our hands up. When it go down, women and man up. They say stay down, and we stand up. Shots be on the ground, the camera panned up. King pointed to the mountaintop, and we ran up. One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, no.
Joined hands with our brothers and marched on Washington, D.C. in support of the dream.
Never underestimate the power of dreams and the influence of the human spirit. We are all the same in this notion. The potential for greatness lives within each of us. Wilma Rudolph.
She pursued those dreams along with her brothers, all of them destined to achieve the desires of their hearts.
You are where you are today because you stand on somebody's shoulders. And wherever you are heading, you cannot get there by yourself. If you stand on the shoulders of others, you have a reciprocal responsibility to live your life so that others may stand on your shoulders. It's the quid pro quo of life. We exist temporarily through what we take, but live forever through what we give. Brennon Jordan.
Sadly, our brothers and sisters cried when our leaders were struck down, assassinated in their prime, Medgar, Martin, Malcolm, and so many others.
Together, brothers and sisters held hands, challenged injustice, and pursued higher goals.
If there is no struggle, there is no progress. Those who professed favor freedom, and yet depreciate agitation, are men who want crops without plowing up the ground. They want rain without thunder and lightning. They want the ocean without the awful roar of its many waters. This struggle may be a moral one, or it may be a physical one, or it may be both, moral and physical, but it must be a struggle. Power concedes nothing without a demand. It never did, and it never will. Frederick Douglass.
Together, they voted, participated, and achieved electoral success.
Change will not come if we wait for some other person or if we wait for some other time. Barack Obama.
Together they yelled, hands up, don't shoot.
No justice, no peace.
I can't breathe.
Black lives matter.
Say his name.
Say her name.
We are not against police. We're against police brutality. Al Sharpton.
Together, they denounced the teaching of his story and appealed the teaching of our story.
We must never forget that Black history is American history. The achievements of African Americans have contributed to our nation's greatness. Yvette Clark.
We step into a world where we pray to God that people will unite, especially the silent, and understand that they must protest racism wherever it exists.
The beauty of anti-racism is that you don't have to pretend to be free of racism to be anti-racist. Anti-racism is a commitment to fight racism wherever you find it, including in yourself, and it's the only way forward. Eljome Alu.
And there you have it. From the ground to glory. We took lemons and we made lemonade with this year's virtual event. On behalf of this year's Black Cultural Alliance, we would like to thank all of our performers, artists, club moderators, our recording team, and everyone else that was vital to making this program a tremendous success. Although we didn't get to meet in person this time, we hope that your spirit was filled from wherever you participated. From the ground to glory, glory to God. God bless and good day.